Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Steam at the Library. I'm Cody from the Okanagan Regional Library. Now today we're going to be covering a piece of software that's near and dear to my heart. It's the audio editing software Audacity. Now this is free and open source, which means if you guys pause the video, check out the description, there'll be a link in there and you guys can download it, run it yourself for free, and I'll show you guys how to make some funny voices in it and maybe we'll learn a little bit of math along the way. Okay? Well, let's get started. So first things first, let's get some audio into Audacity. We're going to select the record icon, this red circle here, and click it to start recording our track. Now you can just say whatever you want into here. You can click and drag to make a selection, so you'd only have to play the parts that you're interested in. And then hit the green play icon to play. You can hear what my sample's like now. I'm going to change this speech in many different ways today. Let's see how this sounds. That was pretty good, but you might have noticed that there is a bit of background noise. You can see there's a little bit of fuzz on the waveform there, so we can trim that off and reduce that noise using the noise reduction effect. And we're going to select a portion of the noise, so we click on that, and click Get Noise Profile. What that'll allow us to do is then select the whole track by double-clicking or hitting Ctrl-A and selecting Noise Reduction and then hit the OK button. From there, we can just trim off the excess. It's good to record a little bit before and after so you can do this process in Audacity. And let's hear what it sounds like. I'm going to change this speech in many different ways today. Let's see how this sounds. That is much cleaner. Great. So, our next trick is going to be applying an echo effect. Now, you might have seen the echo effect in the effects menu, so we can click Effect, then Echo, and just click OK to see what it does. There are some options in there.
I'm going to change this speech in many different ways.
Let's see how this sounds. So, it does a pretty good echo there, but what I noticed there is that it really cuts off far too early. So, we're going to give ourselves a little bit extra time. I'm just going to copy the second part of it because I wanted that to echo maybe one more time cleanly. So I'm just going to copy that whole length of it and paste it using Control V. Once we've done that, we can hit the flatten icon to make it so that part doesn't actually play. You can see it just makes the waveform go completely flat. So now we've got this little bit of extra space here to apply our echo into. We can select the entire track, and then we can apply the echo effect on it again. Now you might notice that double-clicking doesn't work, that's because we've technically got two samples here. But you can just drag over it, or hit Control-A. Let's see what this sounds like.
I'm going to change this speech in many different ways.
Let's see how this sounds. Sounds a lot better. Okay, next trick. To get a robot effect, we're going to have to combine two other effects, the vocoder and the delay effect. Now, the delay effect sounds like it's just going to make it lag behind, but in fact, it's actually going to apply several echo voices in a much different way than reverb works.
So, we're going to first pick the vocoder effect. So, go to Effects, Vocoder, down near the bottom, and what we're going to do is we're going to set the distance to 60, and not much else really needs to be changed here. You can hit OK. I had to record this one a little bit afterwards, so we're using a different voice sample for this one. Sorry about that. And then we're going to apply our second effect, Delay. So, with the same sample selected, go to Effect, Delay, and then set the parameters of the delay function as follows. Set the delay level per echo to minus 10 decibels. This will make it about 3 times quieter than it was originally. Set the delay time in seconds to 0.01. This will give a very, very short delay, but still with noticeable separation between the voices. Set the pitch change per echo to 0.4. This will give a small amount of variation to the voices, which will give it a very multi-layered sound. Set the pitch change effect to low quality pitch shift. The other setting will cause some strange separation at the end of the samples, and we don't want that, so low quality pitch shift it is. Finally, we're going to set the number of echoes very high. I put it to 30. Hit OK to apply, and let's see what this sounds like. I had to record this one a little bit afterwards, so we're using a different voice sample for this one. Sorry about that.
That sounded pretty good, didn't it? All right, on to the next one.
So our next project is making a ghost-sounding voice. So what we're going to do here is we're going to work with this reverb effect. Now, this makes it sound like it's in a tight room and it's bouncing off of a lot of different objects.
I'm going to change this speech in many different ways today. Let's see how this sounds.
It almost sounds like you're in a bathroom or something, right? But the real trick is we're going to reverse it, then apply reverb. So let's give that a go. That's creepy sounding, isn't it? Okay, let's reverse it again. And let's hear what it sounds like.
I'm gonna change this speech.
Pretty cool. It's like there's a bunch of echoes that start shaking out into the speech. And we'll apply another layer of reverb after that.
I'm gonna change this speech in many different ways today. Let's see how this sounds.
Pretty cool. So we'll be starting with pitch shifting now. This is increasing or decreasing the pitch of your voice, so you can make yourself sound a much deeper voice or a much higher pitch voice. So let's go through examples here.
Now all these settings just change their pitch up and down. We'll start with the octave ones. It'll try to automatically detect, but you can ignore and just tweak it up and down.
I'm going to change this speech in many different ways today.
You know, if we just hadn't listened to me talking with that, I would have suspected that was someone else. And you can keep going. You can change the pitch up or down. So let's have some examples.
I'm gonna change this.
Almost like a chipmunk sound. Now, small amounts of variation gives you the best results in terms of quality, but we could push it all the way to some extremes here. So let's see if we can get some very, very weird sounding voiceovers. I'm going to drop this quite a few octaves. Gives you a very low guttural growl, but it doesn't really give you a very coherent speech. So we're going to reduce the amount of drop that we're doing, go only a little bit now. Still quite a bit, but... So if you're trying to do a voiceover for a dragon, that would be a very effective way of doing it. Okay, next up, let's do the equalization tool. Now, there's a couple presets we'll start you off with here. We can select the one labeled telephone. Let's see what our voice sample sounds like when we apply a telephone filter to it. And we can hit the preview button to find out what it sounds like.
I'm going to change this speech in many different ways today. Let's see how...
So a telephone seems to give that weird tinny effect that you get over the phone. You can get a more exaggerated effect by using the walkie-talkie.
I'm going to change this speech in many different ways today. Let's see how...
There's some other filters as well. You could try seeing what you sound like over an AM radio.
I'm going to change this speech in many different ways today. Let's see.
And there are a few other ones that are more for professional use rather than fun use. You can experiment with them if you like. But I just want to show you a little bit about what you can actually do with equalization that isn't the presets. So I'm just going to click the flatten button here to get a flat waveform. And I'm just going to drag some points onto this line here. As you can see, it's not quite anything like what I was doing before. And we can see what effect this is going to have on our voice sample.
I'm going to change this speech in many different ways today. Let's see how this sounds.
I managed to make my very nice microphone sound like a very, very cheap microphone. Neat, right? Okay, let's look a little bit at the theory of how this works.
So to start off, we're just going to start by drawing a wave out on the axis to describe what's going on there. The horizontal axis is time, so as time progresses forward, we move from left to right. The vertical axis does have a physical interpretation as well. If we think of it as a speaker, the speaker vibrating will actually move away from its base resting position, and that amount of travel from that resting position could be what the vertical axis of this is. However, when it's stored on your computer, it's not actually stored on a speaker in motion, so that interpretation has its drawbacks. Most of the time, we're just going to call it the amplitude instead. The amplitude of the wave is the maximum distance between the center of the waveform and the peaks. The measure of how long it takes for a wave to travel from peak to peak is called the period, which is measured in seconds. Now, usually, we don't actually describe how long it takes for a wave to get from peak to peak in terms of periods, instead using something called the frequency. The frequency is the rate at which the wave rises and falls. We measure frequency in hertz, which is the number of rises and falls per second. Something that is 20 hertz is an event that happens 20 times per second, so a wave of 20 hertz would have 20 peaks per second. By using Audacity to zoom in, using Control and the mouse wheel, you can actually see these peaks and valleys. Let's have an example of what I mean when I say adding waves. It's easier to see this if we use a special case. Here I've got two waves. One has a very low frequency and rises and falls very slowly. The other one has a high frequency and rises and falls very, very fast relative to the other one. Adding these two waves results in a waveform where you can kind of see both waves. You can see the broader up and down motion of the first wave with a very rapid fluttering of the second wave over top of it. Using a technique called the fast Fourier transform, you can separate out these two waves to get the big one and the little one separately. This allows you to do all sorts of interesting operations, like change the frequency of waves to make them higher pitched or lower pitched, or change the amplitude of the wave to make it sound louder or quieter. The change pitch effect actually uses this technique. It decomposes each waveform into individual waves of specific frequencies, and then adjusts those frequencies and the amplitudes to get a different effect, such as a higher or lower pitch. The walkie-talkie filter just throws away all the very low and very high frequency waves. The interesting thing about the Fourier transform is it's very efficient. It's so efficient that we go out of our way to find ways to use it. It's used in video, audio, imaging, and all sorts of little mathematical tricks and techniques that are used to make computers go faster. Compressed video or audio actually uses the Fourier transform to save space. The very, very high frequency waves, or the very, very low amplitude waves, can all be safely discarded. So, when you do the Fourier transform on video or audio, you can try to detect these very, very high frequency or very, very low amplitude waves and just discard them. That'll save space. The math of a Fourier transform does require a little bit of complex number theory, so we're not going to get into that today. But it's interesting all the same, and I encourage you to check it out if you're interested. Alright guys, thanks for coming out today. I hope you guys learned a lot, and I can't wait to see what sort of stuff you guys get up to with your editing skills that you learned today. Now, if you're interested in more content like this, the Okanagan Regional Library is posting videos on our channel, so make sure you give us a subscription. We would really appreciate it. All right. Thanks so much for coming out, and enjoy!